President Secretary Austin.
Please, Joe.
Are you still confident in Secretary Austin, sir?
I'm staring at your car. It's like my dog when we tell him, hey, do you need to go to the bathroom? And he's like in his dog bed looking at us like, it's 41 degrees outside, fool. Have you seen it? Welcome back to the show. Dana Loesch here with you. Bottom of this third hour. That's confused Joe. Joe confused. The video. They were asking him about SecDef. And he just shut down. I don't know what he did. He didn't respond. He was confused. By the way, and I wanted to point this out. Listener Adrian shared this. So it came out that Lloyd Austin was diagnosed with prostate cancer. Prostate cancer. And apparently, I guess that was that the surgery that he was having? Because remember when it was first reported, and not just reported, the statement that he released said it was elective. Is that kind of stuff elective? I mean,
as a prostate owner,
yeah, because you have one of those. Because you're a dude.
There is no life that I can imagine that I'm just going to, you know what? I'm going to electively reduce or add to the size of my prostate.
Yeah, I'm just going to go get that worked on.
It's not an elective thing.
I'm going to go get my prostate fiddled with surgery stuff, no. Surgical fiddling.
No.
The prostate.
No.
Sounds not fun. As somebody who does not have a prostate, because, you know, I'm a woman.
Right.
Tell that to some of the people out there who get real confused about bits and pieces. I wouldn't know anything about it. It just doesn't sound elective. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, that sounds medically necessary, not elective. But apparently that's the latest. I just got a lot of questions about that. I mean, it does seem that it was a lot more serious than there was. And you'll forgive me. I'm going through my bookmark system because I wanted to pull up the statement that he put out because he had said, yeah, they said here's literally Department of Defense. Here's the statement. Recent elective medical procedure. A recent elective. What is elective about the prostate thing there? What? Do they understand what that means?
So are they saying he elected to have the cancer removed as opposed to not electing to have the cancer removed?
I mean, I'm looking at... This is so weird. Elective. I mean, this is literally... I am gonna tweet this out to folks, too. This is literally... Like what they had said. They said that it was elective. This is from, this is literally the Department of Defense's website. And it said, he has resumed full duties of his office and remains in contact with senior advisors as he continues to recover after experiencing complications from a recent elective medical procedure. I mean, I'm not a doctor, but I feel like that's not elective. Right?
Yeah, it's not.
So, that is not transparent at all. No transparency here. And I feel like because apparently Biden didn't know about hell, I guess the Pentagon didn't even know. Did the Pentagon know that it had to do with his prostate? I get that the dude, he's an older dude. I get it. He probably doesn't want his bits and pieces all out there. You know what I mean? I get it. But I feel like, too, when you are the Secretary of Defense and you have to sign off, like Stephen Yates told us yesterday, you have to sign off on important things. I just kind of feel like that you have to have a little bit more transparency and you don't just get to have your deputy appointed and nobody knows what's happening and nobody even knows if you're in the office or that you're gone or that it's a serious thing. That's a very important, that's a thing, that's very important. Huh. So Yeah. It does feel like they're hiding something else. Like, why would they do this? Why? Why would you make these stupid errors like this that are just totally needless? So that was from Walter Reed. Okay. Well, it's the Secretary of Defense. I was told it was elective. Apparently it's not elective. Got a lot of questions. So I don't know. Are they going to answer anything like that at the press avail? I'm curious. I'm just kind of blown away over that. You know, they present gender mutilation as being medically necessary, but this is elective.
But it also, to me, it sounds like a little bit of a cover-up where the government doesn't want people to have little faith in their leaders. So they're saying things like this to be like, oh, it was an elective thing, wasn't a big deal. I want to know if this is truly a medical condition. What is his health condition at the moment? He's sec deaf. We need to know this. I mean, if the president goes under anesthesia for any little thing, you know, the vice president is right there standing mm-hmm. by. Everyone's notified.
Mm-hmm.
And it shouldn't be any different in this case.
Yeah. Yeah, it feels like none of this feels like it's elective. None of the stuff. They said he underwent a procedure to treat the early prostate cancer. So they caught the cancer in its early form. And then there were a couple of other complications that went along with that. And that's what they were treating him for. That sounds serious. There's no transparency. And nobody in the government even knew what was going on. His deputy didn't even know what was going on. A lot of concerns over that.